The kids we were brings time travel in 1980s Japan to switch soon. Not too long ago we shared the news that the kids we were was due to arrive on Switch early next year. It's a rather charming game following adventurous kids in the Japanese suburbs, featuring time travel and some lovely visuals. It turns out that it's closer than originally thought, now due to arrive on the eShop on 2nd December priced at $15.99, and regional equivalents, but with 20% off on pre-orders. Developed by GageX, which is known for feel-good and nostalgic games, it's a narrative adventure game that adopts blocky voxel-style visuals, think The Tourist but with a calmer color palette. On mobile it's had plenty of positive reviews, while the game has also won various awards on the Japanese scene. It involves a bit of time travel, a back-to-the-future-esque quest and a setting of 1980s Tokyo suburbs. One prize from its various awards was to have a live-action teaser trailer produced professionally, which emphasizes the childhood friendship and general vibe of the game. You can see that in some of its official description below. Our story begins with Minato arriving in the small town of Kagami, an exceptionally ordinary sort of place in a sleepy suburb of Tokyo. But there's more to this simple trip than meets the eye. Minato has a secret objective. He intends to find his missing father, who is supposedly living somewhere in the area. Our young sleuth Minato wastes no time getting started, and soon finds a puzzling clue to his father's whereabouts. A mysterious notebook left for him with the portentous title The Seven Mysteries. With this notebook as his guide, Minato sets out on a long and difficult journey, not through space, but through time. For his destination is none other than 33 years in the past, the day his father and mother first met. The Switch version has new content compared to the mobile original, with a new bonus episode set after the events of the main game and additional collectibles.